Probably the next award would be for every mom that's here in the audience, but I had to kind of pick one, and so, not that there are going to be other awards in the years that come forward, but when we think about chiropractic as a science and art and philosophy, it's we taught the triune, you know, particularly if you're still going to a self-obsession-based colleges, which those are going away faster than you realize, but you would learn that as a part of our heritage. And I see the triune mom beyond the science, art, and philosophy, but first, you know, she's typically, these triune moms, they're a wife trying to find the balance of that the magic of keeping that marriage just good and healthy, and then secondly, you know, following up with taking care of your kids. And I think the thing that you guys have taught me is, and I've learned very quickly on as being mentors, that your children will always come first. I don't care what number, as long as you can pay your bills, your children should always come first, especially those first 5 years of life when you know as a mom chiropractor you need to nurture. Because you can never go back and replace those five. And when they get away to going to school, there's some freedom to practice more. But the most important thing is never take away that thing that and it's not said from other people's platforms, because maybe that's just not a mom. I'm not a mom, but I get it from you guys in your wombs that, you know, it's important. The most important thing is that nurture component of it. And then the third part of that triune is the business person, where you have to be a part of that business. And this individual, too, is a second-generation chiropractor. I met her in some little old seminar, and she had an amazing practice of cash and just crazy good in this little place called in the state of Ohio. But her crazy husband had to go to a special college to finish up his doctorate degree, and doggone it, for love, she got rid of the practice. I'm going, what are you thinking? I tell people, man, when you plant the practice, you know, fall in love with somebody who's going to stay there, but don't move. You're going to pick it up. Nobody's waiting for you. Nobody's going to wait for you. And sure enough, the relocation started her practice, almost two locations. The fact that her beloved Aaron was able to finish his doctorate degree and his teaching as well. The fact that, you know, Amanda, went through a unique, relationship with Millie coming into the world. I mean, it was everything you weren't expecting. And it taught you to be the most powerful woman, and the fact that sometimes our greatest disappointment is that our birth wasn't as natural, and you had the challenges of those unique disappointments, and yet you didn't give up, and you showed back up to work, and you gave back 100%. Of course, I got Lydia, she's kicking your butt too. So, and so I just wanted to thank you, as just as a triune mom, that you're an example to all of us. And again, it's not always having the largest practice, but it's a practice of good soul. So I'm at your service.
My 4-year-old can explain subluxation to people, and then they pretend justing other kids and all that. But you have helped me tremendously to define what it was I want and how to get there in balance. So thank you.
The balance.
Yes.